How can we reduce sweet cravings with nutrition alone? So sweet cravings is something a lot of my clients struggle with when they first come to me for help. So it's something that I wanted to address. And I can absolutely understand this firsthand because when I had leaky gut and when I had candida, my cravings were through the roof. I would eat, sleep, and breathe sweets. And I'm not joking. Sweets were literally all I could think about all day. At the time, I was unable to have any sort of sugar whatsoever. So the cravings were magnified to the point where I became so obsessive. I would be on Pinterest any chance I got, and I searched for desserts and foods that looked so delicious and filled with sweet stuff, and I would save them because I was like, okay, one day I'm gonna eat these. I would wake up and think of sweets. I would go to bed and think of sweets. It was horrible. You could ask anyone that I worked with that I was around. And it was really sad. I'm not gonna lie. It's actually a true story because I suffered with a lot of gut health issues, and you know that, you know, you have to give up all sugar when you have gut health issues, and that's at least what you're told, but it actually made things worse. And, you know, you're told all these things, you know, different ways on how you can heal your gut. And you think sometimes these professionals and these doctors know what they're talking about, but some of them are so extreme, and some only really focus on your gut health and they forget about optimal health. And reaching a level of optimal health means that everything is working for you and not against you. So you, when you're at an optimal level of health, you have enough energy throughout your day, stable energy, you feel happy, you have consistent moods, you are healthy from the inside out, and you're physically, emotionally, and mentally healthy. That's the key. And every part of your body as a whole is thriving. So if you're someone who is constantly craving sweets, then right off the bat, there are some imbalances and some tweaks that need to be made. I needed to make tweaks when I was craving sweets constantly, day in and day out. It was literally my body telling me I needed something. So how can we reduce sweet cravings with just nutrition alone? So this has a lot to do with the quality of nutrition you're getting in and the quality of your meals on a daily basis. And most importantly, I'm going to say this again, it's not being super restricted with your nutrition in the first place. Because when you are super restricted on your meal plan, then you're not at an optimal level of health, because anyone who is restricting food groups and foods that they enjoy long term, you know, that is going to cause them to not be happy. And it's most likely not going to be in an optimal you're not going to be at an optimal standpoint emotionally or mentally, which means there's no real balance, which is going to cause things to feel off kilter because you're always craving things, you're deprived of things, and your body's lacking nutrients. So you want to take an approach that is really nutrition focused, and first you want to make sure you're getting in enough quality carbohydrates and you're also getting in your micronutrients. Yes. Carbohydrates, I said it. I know that's a bad word for some people, but our body does need quality carbohydrates. Most people think, you know, you have to give up all carbohydrates, but in fact, that's actually going to make cravings worse when you give them all up. So you want to make sure the carbohydrates, of course, are coming from good sources. You have fruits, you have vegetables, you have whole grains, you have beans and legumes, just to name a few. So especially when you're eating foods like fruits and vegetables, fruits have natural sugar, so that will give you a sweet fix right off the bat. And some people will tell you to stay away from fruit because of the fructose, but fruit is healing foods. Fruit provide your body with so many benefits. You do not want to stray away from fruits. And you also want to focus on food volume. We talked a little bit about this yesterday. If you're eating a large amount of food, you will fill up your stomach. So if you're eating a lot of vegetables and a lot of protein and enough high quality carbohydrates, your stomach is going to get full and your gut is going to realize that you're satisfied and you're nourished and, ooh, I'm not, you know, starving. So this will tell your brain you're full and that you're satiated. Satiated just means that you're satisfied. You know, you're not craving anymore. So if you're just snacking throughout your entire day, you're not going to be satisfied and your body is going to think you're still hungry because it's lacking tons of nutrients. And this is where cravings kick in. I talk to a lot of clients. I have them report what they're eating normally for the week, and then I see how we could incorporate it. I ask them how many meals they're eating. They say three, and they've really only had like three snacks, not even meals. So when your body is lacking in nutrients, your body is going to start craving them. And that is why when I gave up all the sugar, meaning all grains and all fruits and all high glycemic vegetables, my body craved them 24/7. I mean, I was dreaming of sweets at one point. That's how bad it was. You could ask Jesse, you could ask friends I worked with. It was bad. Like I couldn't eat anything. Like I couldn't even eat an apple. And my nutrient deficiencies got even worse. So I can tell you firsthand that restricting yourself of these foods is never the solution. I would have healed myself way faster if I didn't go this route. The other thing we want to focus on is water. If you're drinking enough water, you are going to be hydrated, which will lead to fewer signals to your brain telling you that you're hungry, which is typically just a misfiring because when we're dehydrated, our brain thinks we're hungry when in fact we're thirsty. So I'm sure you could see where the problem arises when you're actually eating, when in fact your body's thirsty. So when we have enough water and we're hydrated, our body is going to be a lot more satisfied, which will, of course, reduce any sort of cravings, whether it's hunger or sweet stuff. And lastly, meal timing is super important, and I want to give you a little trick. So if you time all of your meals around the time you tend to snack the most, for example, I snack at 3 p.m. and 10 p.m. That's when I typically feel like I need to pick. So that's when you want to structure your meals around your snack times, and you will no longer be hungry to snack. And instead, if you focus on the foods I spoke about earlier and you're structuring your meals properly, you're now going to get in an adequate amount of food that will leave you feeling, filling up on food rather than sweets. So when you're getting an adequate amount of nutrients, your body's not gonna crave the sugar. It's not gonna crave the sweets. So it's not to tell you that you can never have them, but you're not gonna be having that crazy crave throughout the day. So I know at 3 p.m. I need a small meal, and at 10 p.m. I have a small meal, which is my mug cake. Now you may be wondering, wow, 10 p.m., isn't that super late? Like I shouldn't be eating after 7. The whole topic about eating too late at night is a myth. I can do an entire video discussing that at a later date. But to just give you a little bit of a background and an overview and to keep it short and simple, if you are overeating throughout the day and then you're eating late at night, then you will gain weight. And it doesn't necessarily mean that the late night snack did it, other than the fact that you're just eating too many calories in your day, which is causing the weight gain. And obviously the snack at night is just an addition. So you're already eating in a surplus. So it's not necessarily if the last snack is causing you to go over or if it's you're already over at that point. If you are eating an adequate amount of meals in your day and you leave your smaller meal for nighttime, no matter the time it is, and it's quality protein and carbohydrates, you will not gain weight. Time has nothing to do with it. The amount of what you are eating makes the difference. So lastly, another thing that will prevent any sort of sweet cravings, and I spoke about this not too long ago, it's super important, but it's not going extended periods of time without eating. When we don't eat for long periods of time, our body is hungry and we always want to get our hands on something that's going to give us energy. And what are those things typically that's going to give us energy? Fats and sugar. So when you have quality nutrition throughout the day, you'll get rid of those cravings of, you know, wanting the fats and wanting the sugars. I want to give you some quality balanced meals that can take place of your snacks. So and a lot of these don't even require a lot of cooking. So you would be able to have, you know, as a little snack, which is a little smaller balanced meal, maybe some non-fat plain Greek yogurt with some berries and some cinnamon. You can have, in that meal, you have protein and you have some healthy carbohydrates. You could also do, say, like a tuna fish packet wrapped in some lettuce leaves, throw in some like tomatoes and cucumbers. You can have a high quality protein bar. You want to make sure that it's at least 20 grams of protein. You can do a protein shake with some fruit. You know, those are just a few options on how to create some smaller balanced meals to replace your small snacks, like 3 nuts or a piece of chocolate or 5 wheat thins. Like, those are not meals. And most importantly, I can't stress enough about being overly restrictive. If you completely cut out sugars and snacking, you're just snacking, this is going to make it an unsustainable plan. Unsustainability leads to yo-yo dieting, and we don't want inconsistent results. We want a long-term lifestyle. Everything that I preach about is for lifestyle purposes, not a diet. So that's why it's important to find a plan that also involves these things. You know, you want to make sure you're able to have the sweets, but you don't want to be craving them all day where it's deterring you from your plan. So you don't want to be too hard on yourself. You know, when you're too hard on yourself, it really leads to failure. So you always want to focus on long-term perspective so you can reach your goals for the rest of your life rather than short-term. So I hope you found value in this. If you did, please comment, share, like it, please. I wanted to also give you the opportunity to download my free ebook with snacking tips. If you're someone who needs help with replacing your snacks with smaller meals, you're not sure what to replace them with, you're not sure what, you know, a smaller meal consists of. There's some recipes you could take advantage of. Go ahead, click the link below. All you need to do is fill out your name and your email address, and I will send it to you. Tomorrow is super important. I'm actually going to be talking part 2 on how you could incorporate cardio in your diet that will help you lose weight rather than causing your hormones to go haywire. So if you're a female and you want to figure out how to incorporate cardio without it deterring you from your goals, you're going to want to hop on. This is one of my favorite topics. If you're someone who coaches people, this is probably also very key information to learn if you are working with a lot of females, because no one talks about this issue. It's something that's life-changing for women, and it's also life-changing for myself. So be sure to tune in if you want to get the most benefit from your workouts. So I'm super excited to see you then. I hope you have a fantastic night, and I'll see you tomorrow.